Welcome back. From Jayalalitha's massive front page ads in national dailies yesterday to Mayawati's massive statues, has the personality cult taken over India's political parties? AIADMK leaders may no longer be falling at Jayalalitha's feet, but they're happy to sing for her in the state assembly.
As Jayalalitha completed 1 year in office, people woke up to these front page pictures of a beaming Tamil Nadu chief minister and her list of achievements. The cost, according to sources, a whopping 25 crore rupees. The publicity blitzkrieg wasn't restricted to just newspapers. In the assembly, party leaders and allies sang praises for Amma, quite literally. Among those were Speaker D. Jayakumar and Finance Minister Paneer Selvam. The personality cult spans across parties, from Jayalalitha, Sonia Gandhi, Mamata Banerjee and Mayawati. The Dalit ki beti had risen to unimaginable heights in the male and caste-dominated politics of Uttar Pradesh. This is an identity Mayawati would assert in everything she would do, wherever she was seen. For her rallies, event management companies would be hired to beam a larger-than-life Mayawati to viewers on TV. What shocked the world was this image, a garland of currency notes that was seen as a transformation of sorts from Dalit ki beti to Daulat ki beti. And her attempt to immortalize herself and her party's symbol by spending thousands of crores. Her personal life and her style of functioning, fodder for diplomatic cables.
WikiLeaks ke malik ko, uske desh ki sarkar se, usse pagal khane mein bhejwane ke liye agrah karti hun.
But perhaps it was megalomania that led to her downfall and the people of UP voted Mayawati out for 5 years of self-indulgence and extravagance. With Sanjay Pinto in Chennai, in Lucknow, Anand Zanane for NDTV.
But it's not just about Mayawati and about Jayalalitha. From Sonia Gandhi to Mamata Banerjee as well, has the cult of personality overtaken Indian politics? We have Manish Tiwari of the Congress Party who also joins us in this segment tonight. Let me first take the first question to Mukul Keswan. When you look at the entire political spectrum, it's something that cuts across party lines where these leaders are towering and, you know, overpowering in many ways, aren't they?
You know, let me say that I hold no brief for any of them. But I think it's faintly worrying that in this selection of names that you have, there's a lack of self-consciousness about the fact that all these leaders are in fact women.
Women, yes.
Let me also say that many of these leaders, all these leaders are also single women.
Yeah.
These are all women who have who exercise political power in their own right. I think there are two conclusions to be drawn by about the way in which they are represented. Either that there's a kind of unself-reflective misogyny within our media, because we constantly use the same epithets, megalomaniacal, eccentric, mercurial, unpredictable, about these women. Or the toll of actually rising to the top in Indian politics as a woman
means that
is enormous. Hmm. And I think both are sometimes true. So I'm not suggesting that vulgar display or enormous statues or sycophancy in a legislature are good things. I am suggesting, though, that this set of samples that you've taken should make us reflect about the nature of Indian politics and the way in which...
Okay, who would you add to this? Seriously. I mean, among men, I would add Rahul Gandhi to it because clearly, there's a personality cult around him in the Congress.
Let me say that there are personality cults that people approve of and people disapprove of. I'm old enough to have grown up in Nehruvian India. And while Nehru didn't have giant cutouts of himself, there was some sense in which virtually the entire consensus of the Republic built him up as a giant. I lived through Mrs. Gandhi's time, and even in her lifetime, there were institutions, universities named after her family.
And
we have
continued.
Seen this cult of personality for a long time. And I think what I want to emphasize here is that sometimes this cult of personality is a compensation for the extraordinary isolation that women who don't have access to the Freemasonry of male networks, this is the kind of way in which they make up for it. Because if you look at Jayalalitha, she's a Bangalorean Brahmin girl who gets into Dravid politics through her relationship with Mr. M.G. Ramachandran. In the same way, Kumari Mayawati is someone who is raised in Delhi, who is taken into the maelstrom of UP politics by her mentor, Mr. Kanshiram. It's very difficult for women to actually make their way on their own. And I think sometimes what we see, what this sort of self...
is a reflection of their struggle.
Is a reflection of the extraordinary difficulty and insecurity that this entails.
Do you have the NDTV Profit app? All the markets, all the news and your own homemade, ready-made portfolio available there for you.
We will right now answer what you should sell, what you should buy when markets are down.
Download at ndtvprofit.com/apps. Get the best app from the channel you trust.